All right, everyone, class is in session for the last time in 2014. Listen, hey, everyone, this is Philip Blackett here with a new episode, the last episode of Life in the NBA for the year 2014. Hope you had a great weekend. Hope you had a great holiday season so far. Hope that you're enjoying time with family and friends, wherever you are around this world of ours, whether back at home or enjoying it in some foreign, exotic location, maybe on the beach somewhere. Wanted to do this episode partly because this is going to be my last episode for 2014, and actually the last episode for a couple weeks now. Basically, what's going on is, obviously, we're about a few days before the end of 2014 and the start of 2015, and as I look at my calendar, I'm reminded that I actually have only a few more days here, not only on campus, but more importantly, in this country, before I head overseas. And you might be asking yourself, Phil, what do you mean by overseas? Before I get into that, I'm so rude. I apologize. We actually may have some people that are newcomers here on the show, and I'm already digging into the content for this week's episode of Life in the NBA. And some people may have been asking, what is Life in the NBA altogether? Like, somebody just shared the link to me, and I'm just listening to this for the first time. What is this show all about? So real quickly, I'll get back to the story of where I'm going, you know, on Friday. But essentially, Life in the NBA is a weekly podcast show that I've been doing for the past 18, 19 weeks during my time here at Harvard Business School as a first year MBA student, where essentially each week I'm sharing with you both the good, the bad, and maybe sometimes the ugly of my time here as a business school student, not only to update myself or update friends and family back home as far as what I've been up to, so I don't have to constantly, you know, regurgitate the same things over phone conversations each week, but also, and I would probably argue more importantly, this podcast show is supposed to be helpful for those prospective MBA applicants and students, those who are thinking about business school, wherever they're thinking about business school, even if they're thinking about Harvard Business School, where I'm currently at, that are just curious to know, what is it like to be a student at business school? Can you give me some sort of insider's view on what's happening beyond the admissions websites, the brochures, the consultants, the alumni that have been there about 20 years ago that don't, they have a sense of what school's like, but they don't know recently. So somebody who's currently at the school. And, you know, in addition to what they've been getting before, they just want a little more, I guess, perspective. So this show, what I've thought about when I created the show was essentially, and this is helpful because I'm actually looking back on this now that 2014 is coming to a close, that's ultimately what I wanted when I was applying to business school. Like, I had a number of friends of mine that were going to business school, and, you know, I was trying to find out, what was it like? What was it like to go to class or certain activities? Like, you know, what's the social life over there on campus? Do you have parties? What are the clubs and organizations like? Is it pretty intense when it comes to recruiting? How do you juggle all the classes and, you know, your everyday schedule? Are the people nice? Are they snobby? Are they helpful? Are they collaborative? Are they inspiring? What is it like to be in that particular city, you know, when the seasons change and everything? These are the type of questions that I had for a number of my friends that were currently in business schools all across the country. And if I could get time with them on the phone, I could. I consider myself thankful because I better understand how extremely busy they are every day, especially when I kind of understand it for myself that, honestly, you know, I definitely will work on doing better for 2015 going forward, but also better understand why it may be hard or difficult to stay in touch with everybody and get back to everyone's questions or reach back out to them as quickly as possible when someone asks for you or somebody wants to contact you. So essentially, long story short, this is a way for every week, doing it in 20 minutes or less, basically recapping how my week was in business school. So people can better understand what it's like to be a student here and get the good details, the juicy details, I guess I would say. So anyways, that's the synopsis of it. Basically, Life in the NBA is a weekly 20-minute podcast show where each week I share with you how my life is like at business school as a first-year MBA student, particularly at Harvard Business School. So with that being said, now that that's out the way, why am I leaving in a few days? Like literally leaving like Friday night. So if you're new here and you're not so sure as far as like what things are done in Harvard Business School during the first year, one of the things, one of the programs, one of the areas of study that we go through is called Field. And it's divided into three parts, and we finished the Field 1, and now we're in the Field 2, which has us as students traveling to certain countries, or if you're an international student and your United States is your first country, or is it foreign to you, then somewhere within the United States, where essentially we work on some sort of assignment, some sort of consulting-like project where we work with a certain partner company on a certain product when it comes to bringing a product to market and understanding what it's going to take and working with its small team to make that happen. And essentially applying what we learned the first semester in business school, you know, the marketing, finance, operations, accounting, all that sort of leadership, to being able to now go beyond just case studies and theories and frameworks to now actually applying it real time in the real world with real problems with real companies. Not to say that the case studies we talked about before aren't done with real problems with real companies, but now it's kind of like more so in a sense like we're on the ground running and we're actually applying it in real time. So I'm actually going to be a part of that as well. And I'm going to be traveling to Mumbai, India. Very, very excited to go there. I haven't started packing yet, and I know I definitely will do that this week. So this week will definitely be a real busy week, despite the fact that there's hardly anybody left on campus. I'll share with you why I'm still on campus in a little bit. However, the thing is that I'm just looking forward to travel. Like, honestly, when I was in college, I loved the fact that I was in a position, I was very blessed to be in a position where I could be able to travel to different countries throughout the year, usually during the summertime. But even then, it was like I'd never been to China before, never been to South Africa, never been to Brazil, and other countries along those sort. And so ever since college, I really have pretty much stayed in the United States for past 6 or 7 years and hardly ever ventured outside the United States except for like a quick week trip to Toronto, Canada for a little bit, which was cool too. I haven't been to Toronto before, so that was fun too. But there's a part of me that really, really wants to explore new areas, new environments, new cultures, new countries. Like to be on a long distance flight. Oddly for me to say that, but as long as I'm in a good seat with some leg room and a window, hopefully, and some good movies to watch in the meantime, some good food, I'm pretty much good to go. But ultimately, I think one of the things for me is just being able to get back out there, actually use my passport again, dust it off, and travel to a new place, which I'll be doing in India. Basically, I'll be in India from the 4th to the 14th. Of January and then come back, and then we'll be busy again because we'll have a few things happening the following week, and when we start class that following week, not the next week but the following week after that, we start winter semester classes. So is it, what I realize is it's gonna be really, really busy now, and I'm very, very glad I had an opportunity to really just rest and just chill out after exams for the past week. I was just being able to, you know, if you haven't told by now, I stayed up here during the holidays and during winter break altogether, partly because I just wanted some time for myself. You know, it's one of the things I talked about in a previous episode of Life in the MBA is that business school is a great opportunity for you to reevaluate, revisit, and contemplate where you want to go with your life after business school. And I'm not trying to come up with some deep thinking for you here, but essentially it's one of those things that, you know, once you're done with the exams, you're done with the case studies, and, you know, there's no parties to go to, and everyone's kind of like giving some space and some time to yourself because everyone else is visiting different countries and, you know, visiting family and, you know, relaxing as well, you have an opportunity to be able to think about, you know, obviously reflect on how your first semester was and also reflect on what things are interesting to you after doing that first semester. Are there certain classes you want to take second semester, or, and in my case, second year, since, you know, second year for me at HBS is all electives. Or you kind of got a sense of what I want to do as far as electives. It may change after this next semester, but it's good to at least have some sort of idea what you want to do. And so part of it, as far as me being up here, was obviously, you know, taking some time to rest and get myself back to where I needed to be after stressing out over exams. And two, just reflecting off what I've learned thus far, and ultimately, without having to defend myself or be subject to all these other opinions, whether back at home or otherwise, about what I should or shouldn't do, what I should or shouldn't consider for careers, I could be able to do that on my own and say, you know what? What is it I really want to do? What will make me happy? Where am I in particular to where I'm trying to achieve with my life at 30? Obviously, a lot of people say that's young. To me, it's just like the fact that I'm growing gray hairs obviously tells me a whole nother story. But essentially, you know, what is it I want to do now? Like, this has been a huge year in my life, you know, basically fulfilling the dream come true I've had, you know, for over 10 years now as far as a dream to come to Harvard Business School. And I'm the type of person that absolutely, you know, I appreciate it, I revel in it, I take advantage of it and go all out with it. But not too long after that, I'm starting to think about what's next. Maybe that's just me being type A. Maybe that's just me just wanting to really get the best out of what life has to offer. Maybe that's the grandmother and mom in me that's just like, okay, this is great. What else can we do? So it's always helpful just to take some time and just to think about what is it you want to do in life? What is it you want to do post MBA when you get your degree and you head off campus? I mean, obviously, we're 1/4 of the way done now, so it's not that much longer. I mean, essentially 3 semesters left and that's it. Even though the student loans don't go away that quickly, though, I'll say. So that's pretty much been it. It's been very relaxing. I've had a lot of different revelations and thoughts. And honestly, this has probably been the best investment as far as time I could give to myself this year. And I'm very, very thankful. I used to think it wasn't a good idea for me to spend time up here on campus and seeing how a lot of my friends are traveling around the country. Some people going to Chile, Brazil, Africa, Thailand, Bangkok, all these different places, like already leaving before we actually do our field projects, which is great. I'm actually not going to do that. I'm just going to go to India for my project and then come back. Number of reasons why for that one, we won't really go into that right now, but just essentially, you know, it's very quick to still experience FOMO or fear of missing out when you're not even in school. I think part of it to me is I just feel really good about where I am right now and where my life is going, and really understanding what is it I want to do. And once I kind of have a good sense of where I want to go, then I can always start making moves towards fulfilling that dream, that next dream of mine, and going to prepare myself for that next step in my life. So anyways, enough about that. That's essentially where I've been thus far. I had a great time watching, you know, TV when I didn't have time, watching a bunch of basketball and football games and movies, reading some books, just taking it easy. And now it's just like I got a few more days left, got some work to do still. Just preparing for next semester, and also hoping to take a day or two this week just to kind of explore around Boston if I can, if it's a little bit warmer, because I haven't had a chance to do that either while I was up here in school, because you're just taking it all in, like, you know, drinking from a fire hose, right? So obviously that's essentially what's going on. This past week I spent Christmas Eve with a friend of mine. Basically got to spend some time with her family up in, I think it was like close to Malvern, Massachusetts, and which was, had a great time there, and Christmas had a low key here. And you know, like I said before, New Year's Eve probably this week heading into it. Probably do something around Boston. Spend New Year's Day, the first day here in Boston. More than likely, the first day will probably be finishing up packing, doing laundry, and just making sure everything else is good to go, because that next day, January 2nd, we pack our bags. Well, we already packed our bags by that point, but January 2nd, we actually pack the car in and head on over to the airport and make our way to Mumbai via London and that sort of thing as well. So what am I saying with essentially 5 minutes left or so on this podcast? I didn't have any plans here. I didn't have any agenda here. I just wanted to talk to you. I just wanted to share what's on my mind as it comes by. I guess you call it freestyling. Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't. But essentially, it's this. When I first started this podcast, I was a little bit nervous, honestly. And part of the reason is because there weren't any other podcasts from current MBA students doing this sort of thing where they're basically sharing parts about their lives, in some sense putting themselves out there, being vulnerable, sharing both the good and the bad, and sometimes ugly about how life is like. Also the sense that, you know, people may look at me as a representative of a certain business school, which I am very quick to say, look, I'm just a student, and my views are just my views. And I don't want people to misinterpret that as thinking that this is what a certain school thinks and how a certain school sees things, because I don't want people being confused. I don't want any of that drama that could come out of that as well. I just want to be able to share my candid views, my candid opinions, and, you know, whether you like it or not, or if you agree with it or disagree with it, you're more than welcome to do so. But hopefully, by me taking time each Sunday for the past 19 weeks to share with you what's been going on with me and how I've seen business school and what takeaways I could leave with you, especially if you're considering business school, hopefully that's something that's helpful to you. Hopefully that's something that's worthwhile, and especially if you've been a long-time listener of this show, I appreciate that. And as I end this show, and it's, like I said, it's the last show for 2014, I just want to express my gratitude and appreciation for everyone who does take the time, 20 minutes or so, to listen in. For people who this is the first time they even hearing of me or being engaged with me in that sense, I appreciate it. I hope this has been helpful to you. I hope that this has been entertaining, and in some sense, I hope this was empowering for you, especially if you consider in business school, for that matter. Like I said, you know, I'll be out of town literally starting this Friday, and then I'll be back on the 14th, I believe. So that means, look on the calendar real quick, that means, yep. So the Sunday right before Martin Luther King holiday will be the next time that you hear from me, which will probably be, which obviously just look on the calendar, it's not probably, it is January 18th on a Sunday. By that time, I should probably have been caught up on jet lag for the time being and already up and running with many stories to tell you about how India was, what I've learned, and ready to get started, because it'll be another busy week already from that front as well, and I'll share with you more detail about that when the time comes. So with that being said, this will probably be the shortest episode of Life in the NBA this year, and that's fine. That's perfectly fine, because I know some episodes we've gone a little bit over, so hopefully this balances everything. But like I said before, tune in Sunday, January 18th. By that time, I should be back from India, well-rested, ready to go, for the first episode of Life in the NBA for 2015. Thank you so much for listening in. Feel free to share this with other people if you feel like this is helpful. We'll have plenty more episodes going forward. Like I said before, I still stand by it. Ever since we got started from episode one, we plan to do episodes all the way until graduation day. And from that matter, I hope this is going to be something that people will be listening to for many weeks or months, or if not years, and hopefully spur some sort of movement where other business school students from different business schools do something similar. You know, I think that'd be great to be able to share, you know, what life in the NBA is like from, you know, Duke or Kellogg or Wharton or UT Austin or Arizona State, different schools of that matter. So hopefully this helps people understand that you can do it too. Just because I'm doing it doesn't mean that I'm the only one who could do something like this. I definitely encourage people that are considering doing this, maybe start it next semester, go for it. And for that matter, if anything else, that would definitely make sure that I'm not the only one doing this. So anyways, we'll see how that turns out next semester. We'll see how it turns out next month. We're getting close to 20 minutes, so we can call it a day here. Thanks again. Like I said before, if you want to subscribe for future episodes going forward in 2015, head on over to www.lifeinthenba.com. www.lifeinthenba.com. There you can subscribe for free for future episodes when I post them, which the next one after this will be January 18th, 2015. And also, if you're on iTunes as well, definitely be able to check it out. Just search Life in the NBA or Philip Black in iTunes, and boop, the episodes will be right there for you to download, listen to, in on demand, whenever you want to, wherever you are in the country or around the world, whatever you're doing, whatever time is helpful or convenient for you. So, with that being said, that's pretty much all I have to say. Happy New Year's. Happy winter break. Have a great day. Have a good rest of the year. See you next year, 2015. It's been great. Thank you so much for listening in. And I'll see you in a few weeks.